Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Today we are going to discuss about lecture number 15, and that is about learning resources, objectives of instruction, types of instructions, material, and audiovisual aids, the value of audiovisual aids in learning, and types of audiovisual aids. And we will discuss only these topics in this lecture, and hopefully you will understand it. First of all, what is meant by instructional materials? You know that the material that is being used in classrooms during instruction, so that we call instructional material. So administrative leadership carries the responsibilities of obtaining and allocating instructional materials necessary to promote educational program and development and students' learning. Because administrative leadership basically they follow the curriculum, or they follow the syllabus and the needs of the student and teachers, and accordingly they provide such instructional resources or materials to the teacher and organizations also. The use of instructional materials implies that learners are studying at one remote from the author who, by preparing the learning materials, is showing the effect that learners can pursue their studies in their own way, in their own time and in place of their choosing, is probably the biggest single advantages of and a motive for proving the instructional material. Now there are some objectives of instruction. Definitely when we do something and we set our objectives, that what we are to do during some specific time. So during instructions, definitely there are some objectives, like course objectives may be varied. You know that every subject has its different objectives, either by liberal reasons or in order to adopt courses to the different aptitudes of the individuals or the different needs of the organizations. And similarly, the material which are used in individualized learning. You know that individualized means that if a student is not getting in the classroom, so that student is being provided with a special instruction as per their need. So accordingly, the individual may be treated and may be considered under the three broad headings, like textual material, audiovisual materials, and computer based materials. So it has been already sealed that distance teaching program is called individualized. Most of the distance learning systems throughout the world, rather that is in Western or Eastern country system, usually are print based and likely to remain so. All successful distance learning systems are built on well designed, learner centered, self instructional print materials, etc. Moreover, we can say that these materials comprise of all textual and all year materials that can be run off in large numbers on a duplicator or printing machine to be used by pupils, students or trainees. Facilities for production of such materials are now available, you know, in practical every formal and non-formal institutions. And they have become one of the most basic and widely used of all educational tools. Wherever there is a system of teaching or learning, so in this point of view, print is intellectually superior medium than television. By comparison, encourages learner to be passive, mindless and unimaginative. Certainly, a great deal of education is concerned with the factual learning, the understanding of generalized or abstract principles, and with logical arguments. And print is very strong medium for developing and acquiring these skills. Now, there are some types of instructional materials, like what are those types, like books, pamphlets, etc., which are already published and normally the students are to be given. With these books, rather it is written by a special you can say organization, or you can say the specific authors, specifically especially written WOP around study guide to already published materials, and specially written self-teaching text, that is tutorials in print, workbooks for use along with the audio tape or video tape, CDT means computer-based teaching, or practical work, etc. Okay, self-text, project guide, notes on accreditation requirements, bibliographies, etc. Maps, charts, photographs are there, posters are there. Materials similarly from the newspaper, journals and periodicals. Handwritten materials passing between learners and tutors. In audiovisual aids, we can use such type of materials. Those have audio and also the visual source for the tutors. An outstanding development in modern education is the increased use of supplementary devices by which the teachers, through the use of more than on sensory channel, helps to clarify, establish and correlate accuracy, concepts, interpretations and appreciations. It increases knowledge, arouses interest and even evokes worthy emotions and enriches the imagination of children. Learning takes place at three levels: direct experiences, vicarious experiencing and symbolic experiencing. Thus, audiovisual materials are quite helpful in instructions. They supply a concrete basis for conceptual thinking, and they give rise to meaningful concepts to words enriched by meaningful associations. And in this context, the researchers have also recommended that in education, we should appeal to the mind chiefly through the visual and auditory sense organs, since it is possible that 85% of our learning be absorbed through these. The value of audiovisual aids to learning. What is the value? Value means like audiovisual aids are potent starters and motivators. When the child finds learning made easy, interesting and joyful with the help of sensory, as he feels motivated. He can't build attend to an increasing procedure going on before him. Direct, concrete, contrived, dramatized experiences add test, interest and vitality to any training situations. As a result, they enable students to learn faster, remember longer, gain more accurate information and receive and understand delicate concepts and meanings. Thus, learning becomes meaningful, enjoyable and effective. Audiovisual aids give variety to classroom techniques. Like they generally represent a rest from the traditional activities of the school. While using them, the child feels experiencing something different, and variety is always attractive to the child as well as to the adult. Audiovisual aids provide a change in the atmosphere of the classrooms. They allow some freedom from the formal instructions of the traditional time. While using sensory aids, the pupils may move about, talk, laugh, question and comment upon, and in other ways act in natural manner as they used to do outside the classroom. The attitude of the teacher should also be very friendly and cooperative. In this way, school work is motivated when people work because they want to do it and not because the teacher wants them to do. So many of these aids provide the child with opportunities to handle and manipulate. Like what type of opportunity? Means opportunity to touch, feel, handle or operate a model, specimen, picture, map, press a button or turn a crank gives an added appeal because it satisfies temporarily at least the natural desires for mastery and ownership. Arguments supply the context for sound and skillful generalizing, like book's lack of specificity, the warmth, indeed some of the unutterable poignancies of concrete experiences through direct, purposeful, first-hand experiences and semi-concrete audiovisual experiences, where we can supply the context for sound and skillful generalizing. Audiovisuals educate children for the life in this modern complex world. Like there was a time when life was very simple. Children learned through direct experiences, the rudiments of knowledge. But ours is a complex world. We live in a push-button age when comfort has a terrific appeal, but there is no easy route to learning. So there is no magic osmosis. Effective learning is still the old-fashioned formula of 19th perspirations and 1/10th inspirations. Naturally, therefore, more must be done to determine how teaching is accomplished easily and speedily. More is the need today than before. Audiovisual aids can play a major role in promoting instructional understandings. These aids can bring about mutual understanding and appreciation of cultural values and ways of living among the different nations of the world. Enlightened and sympathetic attitudes can be developed among the school children through this media. Films and radio programs can be exchanged among the different countries. Colored slides on work of different countries lead to mutual appreciation of Eastern and Western cultural values. To conclude, in the word of McCoy and Roberts, audiovisual aids wisely selected and intelligently used amuse and develop intense and beneficial interest and so motivate to the pupil learning. So this properly motivated learning means improved attitudes, permanency of impressions, and rich experience, and ultimately more wholesome living. Then there are some drawbacks, like audiovisual aids are not the panacea for all instructional aids. Films, recordings, televisions, etc. These are all very good to improve teaching, but teachers and books can't be replaced by these aids. Reading, writing, and speaking will continue to be considered fundamental and fundamental endpoints of instructions. Audiovisual aids are not aids to teaching. Audiovisual aids are aids to children rather than to teachers. Aids to learning rather than to teaching. They do not make teaching easier. They do not lighten the work of teachers. Their use requires a considerable additions to the time spent in planning and preparing lessons. Audiovisual aids are not the ends but means. Audiovisual aids are means to an end. End is good learning on the part of the pupil. Audiovisual aids are not designed to amuse the pupil, rather they are to increase his interest in and his comprehension of the topics being studied by presenting several slants on it, especially through his two most used senses, sights and hearing. Now, when is an instructional aid? An instructional aid is any device that assists an instructor to transmit to learner facts, skills, attitudes, knowledge, understanding and appreciation. A visual aid, that is an instructional device that can be seen but not be heard. An audio aid is an instructional device that can be heard. An audiovisual aid is that device which can be heard as well as seen. Okay, types of audiovisual aids. Generally, we divide the audiovisual aids into five types. The first type is aids through the ear, means auditory. And that is phonograph and radio that comes under aids through the ear. In second type, that is aids to the eyes, and that is called visual, like motion pictures, stereoscope, the camera, the chalk or whiteboard, the flannel board, the bulletin board, pictorial materials, and representations, maps, globes, diagrams, etc. In third type, aids to the eyes and ears, that is called audio visual, and that is sound, motion pictures, televisions. And in fourth type, that is aid through activity, like the school journeys, the objects, specimens, model collections. Normally when teacher use models into the classrooms to explain the concept of any topic, so that is called aids through activity. Then miscellaneous, that is fifth type of audiovisual aids, and like your dramatization and booklets, newspapers and magazines are under miscellaneous audiovisual aids types. Actually, basis is classification upon the kinds of experiences presented to the aids. He call it the cone of experience, like the range of experience as described earlier to audiovisual aids as classified by him is between direct experience and pure abstractions. So these divisions are not intended to be rigid. They overlap and sometimes blend into each other. The author desires the cone to be a visual metaphor or learning experiences depicting the various items in the order of increasing abstractions as one proceeds from direct purposeful experience, which is the bedrock of all education. It was all about you can say the topics that we earlier described. So still, if you didn't subscribe my channel, please subscribe it and remain with me for more updates and updated lectures. Take care, Allah Hafiz.